Hello everyone, it is Patty's Hobby World again. Part three of this beautiful butterfly. Let me bring it in so you can see the details. So we finished the green. So it goes nice against the yellow. And the yellow came out really well. The green came out good, but I think I could have done made it a little bit more vibrant, but that's okay. But so far so good. So now we're gonna go down to the second half. I mean, well, the tail, the bottom lower portion of the butterfly. And I'm gonna open up, make sure we got plenty of light. Okay. Thank you all for coming back. I appreciate you guys viewing my content and subscribing, of course, and liking. Hit that notification button so when you want to watch more of my videos, you'll get a notification. Okay, all right, so let's get started. What I wanted to do as I'm thinking through my, let's do blue and then let's do purple. Okay, so we've got our little swatch thing out, nice and dark. Okay, this is dark as well. I can go between both of those. Matter of fact, this got more of a midnight blue, so I'll take this one away. Then we have our medium, and then we have our light. And then we have our, I have to use a pencil for the more shinier areas. And then we'll leave a little bit of whiteness around so it creates a little more vibrant. So we're going to start with the pencil first. I feel a little bit more safer with starting with the pencil first. And so let's go for there. So what I'm going to do is just move around. Move around this and see what we can come up with. I thought about doing all of this in pencil, which I could, but let's just keep going for the sake of and see what we come up with in terms of using different mediums. And see how it goes. Now I'm going to take advantage of some of this white paper. Well, not, it's not really white, but and create some of the I was supposed to do purple down here. Well, that's okay. I can stay. Let's just stay right in here. Let's stay right there. Okay, and I'm not worried about that because I can cover that up with the purple. So let's just stay right there. Because we're going to do purple underneath for the lower portion. above this tube here. So we'll go like right there. Or maybe we'll go here. We'll go there. So we'll hit this tube. Hope everyone had lunch. I had to run around and do some errands. That a shadow. To do with the umbrella. So I'm just going to leave it there for right now. See what we got. What color I'm going to color it. right, so we're just going to keep at it. And that wasn't too bad. Just make it official. Let me just erase it. Because we're going to be on this side. This side of the... kind of left a thing. Okay. Let's see what we got next. I think the next color is going to be... Yeah, that's perfect. All right, so we're going to use the next color. And just be careful. Just make sure I know where I'm at. Let's start up here. Just, I want to see what it feels like. See what it looks like before I really commit. And I'm always going to do this line so that there's a... You probably can't see it with the green and the yellow. And by the time I'm finished, you won't see it after I'm done. All right, so let's see what we have. Just gonna go slow with this. I may have to go a little darker. That's okay, because I can always Okay, it's just going to take some time, you know, so it's not going to... But we'll get it. As we go darker and darker, and as we pick up more yeah, but that looks good. Yellow, green, blue, and then purple. You know, something different. I think the other side of the this ladybug, I'm gonna do like something totally different. I may go gray monotone again. And see if I can create some like sparkly shiny with the grays. But let's just see. Let's not look good right now. It's gonna be darker in there, so no worries. These little spaces, I can color them in just to see what they're gonna do for me later. Because this is my medium marker. I've designated it as my medium marker, so. Is that it? Is that the bar? Okay. Get an idea. All right, I'm just going to move to the second marker just because I want to see. Just want to see where I'm at. Let's do, we need to do this because this is actually the side. And I like to take full advantage of a side. I like doing that. Matter of fact, I didn't even do it over here, so I need to go back up there and do it. I will, I actually will. I'll get up there and do it. Here's our line, so we gotta go this way. Okay, so I create that nice little... So far so good. I'm gonna put a little yellow.
Let me see. Just create some hue. Okay. I feel like I gotta do something in here. How about that? Alright, let's, which color did we choose for the dark? Was it this one? No. So that needs to go way over there. I think it's this one. Yeah. A little bit more, you know, bluey. See the difference? See the difference of a heavier push on the brush and then just a nice... So that's the difference. That's what you get when you push too heavy down on the brush. So that's the difference. I like this better. Of course, my hand shook a little bit right there. But that's okay. I won't need any black because this blue is dark enough. So there will be no need for black. And I may have to find another color. So I'm just looking for shading, darker recesses. Yeah, this marker, oh, well, there you have it. We can use the tip, boom. Oh, much better. There you have it.
Thank you for watching. Stay inspired. Color, color.